Today I'm going to answer all of your questions about this 2000 watt continuous wave laser cleaning machine by Fortune Laser. We'll talk about all of its advantages and disadvantages compared to a pulsed laser cleaning machine. Then I'll show you how it works, and last we'll talk about the different models and the price. First, why did I get another laser cleaning machine when I already had this 200 watt pulsed machine? One word, speed. Speed is the primary advantage that a continuous wave laser has over a pulsed laser. This FLC2000 is a large format continuous wave machine made for removing rust from large items quickly. Unlike a pulsed machine, which uses shock waves to remove rust, paint, grease, and other contaminants from the metal surface, this 2000 watt continuous wave machine uses raw power to incinerate rust from the surface. And that brings us to the first disadvantage. Heat. Unlike the pulsed laser, this continuous wave laser has a much higher chance of overheating and warping thin sheet metal. It's crucial to keep the laser moving along, and even then, it's still possible to warp metal depending on the thickness and the amount of power being used. The second disadvantage of this continuous wave machine compared to a pulsed laser cleaning machine is that while it excels at removing rust, it isn't ideal for paint, grease, or oily surfaces because it just burns them off rather than removing them with shock waves. It can definitely remove these things, but there's fire and smoke, and afterward, the surface of the metal has a thin layer of soot. The pulsed machine leaves a clean, bright metal surface. Here's the 2000 watt continuous wave machine cleaning painted parts. And here's the same machine cleaning oily or greasy parts. Plenty of fire and smoke. Now, here is a 200 watt pulsed machine cleaning painted parts. And the pulsed machine cleaning oily and greasy parts. While there is still some smoke, the results are much cleaner. While both machines are effective at removing rust, this is where the FLC2000 shines because of its speed and capability of removing heavier rust. When it comes to painted or oily, greasy surfaces, I prefer the pulsed laser cleaner because of the bright, clean surface it leaves behind, literally ready for primer and paint. I was cleaning a lot of engine parts and thinner sheet metal when I purchased the pulsed machine. Now that I have some bigger projects, like a rusty frame and a trailer to restore, the continuous wave machine is superior for those. So which machine should you choose? Well, it all comes down to your projects. Let me know below and I'll be glad to share any experience I have to guide you in the right direction. I find that these two machines complement each other very well. For example, on a large painted item, I'll clean it first with a continuous wave machine. And then I'll follow up with the pulsed machine to remove any soot and leave a bright, clean surface ready for some fresh primer and paint. But for large, rusty items, you can't beat this machine. I did a speed test of these two machines, each cleaning half of a rusty steel rim. The FLC2000 was 11 times faster than the FLC200. Because this FLC2000 is so powerful, it's liquid cooled instead of air cooled like the FLC200. It does still require clean, dry, compressed air. You don't need a large compressor. I use this 13-gallon 2-horsepower Viva compressor, and it does the job. But you will need an inline filter to separate moisture from the air. Being liquid cooled, it requires distilled water or an automotive grade coolant if it's stored in temperatures that can get below freezing. One important note is that both of these machines have an ambient temperature range in which they can be used. The FLC2000's operating range is 50 degrees to 104 degrees Fahrenheit or 10 to 40 degrees Celsius. So here in Ohio, that leaves about 7 to 8 months out of the year that I can use this machine in my unheated shop. I'm guessing that the limitation on the lower temperature is to prevent condensation from forming inside the lens, or maybe it's something to do with the refrigerant and the heat exchanger. These machines come pre-filled with refrigerant if shipped by ground. So the cooling system is a little bit more complicated than the air-cooled pulsed machine. The additional cooling requirements make these machines a bit bigger and heavier than the air-cooled machines. Aside from changing out the coolant used during wintertime to distilled water used during the summertime, the only other maintenance I've had to do on this machine was replace the protective lens inside the cleaning head after about 5 months of use. As you can see, this is a pretty simple process, and extra lenses were included with the machine. The best way to extend the lifespan of these lenses is to use a fan like I do to push or pull the smoke and debris outside away from the cleaning gun.
If being used in an enclosed area, a fume extractor or large exhaust fan is definitely recommended for this, as well as maintaining the air quality for the operator.
And I'll be testing out a fume extractor in next week's video.
It's when the smoke and debris come in contact with the protective lens that they burn onto the surface. And a dirty protective lens will reduce the effectiveness of the laser.
By the way, the Pulse machine also has a limitation on the ambient temperature, but it's able to be used as long as the temperature is above freezing, so normally there's no problem with that in this garage. I'll put a link to a video all about this Pulse laser machine in the description if you want to learn more about it. One area where the FLC2000 surpasses the Pulse laser is cleaning heavy rust and even scaling rust. When I reviewed the FLC200, I found that if I cleaned heavy rust, the surface would be rust-free. But if I scraped off a scaling, there would still be rust underneath. The 2000 watt continuous wave laser handles this much better. If the rust has very heavy scaling, I may need to clean it once, then scrape any remaining areas that still have bits of scaling, exposing the underlying rust, then laser clean it again. This machine is going to be perfect for cleaning my rusty truck frames, rusty engine blocks, exhaust manifolds, rusty steel rims, or any other heavy-duty rusty parts.
First, let's talk about the power cord. This uses 220 volts, and it doesn't come with any specific type of plug on the end because different countries use different types of plugs. You can either hardwire it or add your own plug. So I installed this one. Now I have one 220 outlet in my garage, and I installed it specifically for this compressor, which uses a different style of plug. So for me to plug this into that wall, I needed to purchase the biggest, blackest adapter. And this now plugs into the adapter. And now my adapter will plug into the wall. Now I can power on the FLC2000. And once that power supply is turned on, the coolant within the machine begins to circulate. And then the laser turns on with this key. And once the machine is on and warmed up, it usually takes around 5 minutes or so, this blue light will come on and we're ready to go. And while this is warming up, let's talk about the air pressure. Now, any laser cleaning machine is gonna require clean, dry, compressed air. So I have an air line here. And this compressor uses a 220 outlet, which I only have one of. So I have the second compressor here, and this one does not have a built-in filter on it, nor have I installed one yet. So I currently have the hose from this compressor going into the moisture trap on my big compressor, and then that comes out to this hose here. And you can see in the time it took me to explain all of that, this is ready to go. Something else you need when using this machine is a way to extract the fumes out of your workspace. You can either work outside, or I like to work right by the door with the box fan blowing any smoke and fumes outside. Now I've put a piece of old sheet metal down on the concrete floor in the garage because the laser will strip any sort of sealant that is on the concrete. And today, we'll clean this old brake drum. All right, the tank is full, compressor shut off, and you can hear this machine itself is actually really quiet. Once in a while during use, this fan in the back will kick on, and that's not even that loud. And you can see that inside this gray cover, you have all kinds of cables in here. There's a cooling line going to and from the unit. There's an air line, some electrical wires, and this big one here in the center. This is the actual optical fiber for the laser itself. And that's the main thing that you don't want to bend too much. And behind this door is the protective cover for the laser. And here's a quick look at the menu. This is all touchscreen. You have your scanning frequency, scanning width, peak power, duty cycle, and frequency. Over here on the right, you have technology, which is where you go to save your settings. And here you have more settings, which require the password. But I've found that I never really need to mess with any of these. And monitor shows you all the different sensors and switches throughout the unit, gives you your voltage, as well as your temperatures, and it's gonna let you know if anything is out of spec. This simply turns the laser on or off, so now it's not ready to use, now it is. And this one down here, this will turn green when I open the switch here on the door. And this last one here is just the indicator light, as you can see is a line, and you can also switch it over to a dot. And I kind of like the line because it gives you a preview of the width of your scan. So let's go into technology here, and our scan width is 50 millimeters. We'll bump that up to 100. The max of this machine is 300 millimeters. Scanning frequency is set at 100 hertz, which is a little bit on the finer side. We'll go down to 50 for this test. I'll leave the peak power on at 2000. And duty cycle, I've never really found the need to change that or change this frequency down here. So now import the settings, save and return. Glasses on. So now you can see how much faster the continuous wave machine is compared to the pulsed. But if you look close, there are a lot of etch marks on the surface here. And that's just something that you're gonna get with the more powerful 2000 watt continuous wave laser. Also, it's a little bit warmer. This has been sitting for about 30 seconds, but right here, it's still pretty hot, definitely over 200 degrees. Over here on this side, it's a little bit cooler. And again, you can see all these etch marks from the laser. Now we're going to do a second rusty drum with different scanning frequencies and see how we can change the result of these etch marks in the surface. First, we're going to go to the max scanning frequency, which is 100 hertz on this machine. And that's going to give us a little bit less aggressive of an etch on the surface. And on the other side of the drum, we're gonna do a low scanning frequency. Let's try 10. It looks like 30 is as low as we can go. So it bumped it up to 30 for us. So we'll do 30 on the other half. And now you can see a clear difference between 100 hertz and 30 hertz on this side. Here's a close look at the 30 hertz and the 100 hertz. You can just hear how rough this one is as I drag my thumbnail across it. And while 100 hertz preserves the surface a lot better than 30 hertz, a pulse laser is gonna be your best solution for ultimately preserving the original surface. Here's an old flywheel that's been sitting outside for a few years. You can see it's a very rusted surface, lots of scaling. And for very heavy scaling, the lower scanning frequency is actually gonna break up some of that scaling rust better than the 100 hertz scanning frequency. And we'll do the next section at 100 hertz just for comparison. So you can see we have heavier etching on the left, and here on the right it looks a little bit more like a cast surface, but let's scrape it. You see we still have some rust that didn't get removed because it didn't really etch that surface like this side did. So there are definitely times where you're going to want to use that lower frequency. So let's put this back somewhere in the middle, say 50 hertz, and we're gonna go all the way to 300 millimeters for our scan width. And now we're gonna bump the scan width down to 20 millimeters. And I took this out of the direct sun so you can get a better visual of the surface. And from this point over, I did with the 300 width, and you can see it's a little bit different, a little bit darker than the other side. And that's because that 2000 watts is more dispersed over 300 millimeters instead of 100 like it was over here. But then when I went back with 20 millimeters, you can see it looks cleaner. I think it actually started to melt the surface a little bit. I even went over where I previously went with 100 hertz, and you can see here, it actually altered the surface to the point where it actually etched it to the point of melting it a little bit. Look at that right there. And that's because that 2000 watts was condensed into an area over 20 millimeters.
The price for this FLC2000 was $5,700, delivered to my door, all duties paid. However, that was before any current tariffs were enacted. So prices may vary depending on your location. And also, I got this in 2024. And as newer, more powerful machines are introduced to the market, the current machines will come down in cost. Fortune Laser offers a variety of different power levels for their continuous wave machines. We have 1,000 watt, 1,500 watt, this 2000 watt, they have a 3000 watt, and even a 6000 watt machine. Although the 6000 watt machine requires three phase power, not 220 volts like the other ones do. I asked, and Fortune Laser does offer air cooled versions of the continuous wave machines in 1500 and 2000 watts. However, the price for an air cooled version of the continuous wave machine is gonna cost more than a liquid cooled version of the same machine. I'll put a link down below in the description to Fortune Laser's website where you can find this machine and request an exact quote. Do me a favor and tell them you came from Sixth Gear Garage. If you have any other questions, post them down in the comments and I'll be glad to answer. Thanks for watching.